Hello guys, and welcome back to this vlog series where I find a photo that I find really cool, take the aspects I like from it, and make my own photo inspired by this other photo. It does still need a name, this vlog series. If you have any clue, please let me know, because I can't just keep calling it the vlog series where I take a photo from someone else, analyze it, take the aspects that I really like, and create my own photo with it series. Because that is way too long. So last time we did a self-portrait, we created it. I like to call you and me a team, because I feel you guys keep me motivated by watching my videos. And I hope I teach you something, so you guys feel like I am part of your creative team as well. Okay, so the photo that we will be covering in this week's episode of the vlog is a photo by a photographer named Gijs. He's from the Netherlands. And he's put out some really cool work. You should check his Instagram out, it's linked below. A couple of weeks ago he bought a new lens and camera, and he took some cool photos of it, including this one that I wanna use for this vlog series and take my own version of. What I really like about the photo is the lighting and the cleanness. I don't know if I'll be able to create a setup that allows for such a clean photo, but I will try. My spin on this, I'm not sure what I will change. I will just try. My camera has a bit more personality, it's not brand new. The lens might be new. but I think I'll be making it a bit less clean, even though I do really like that. And giving the camera a bit more personality. I will be taking this photo with my phone because, well, if I'm taking a photo of my camera, my phone has a better camera than my backup camera. No, I don't really dislike anything. I will probably focus most on the personality for the photo or for the camera, and the lighting, which I really like. It is very nice and clean looking. I will try to create a nice lighting setup and some nice clean background that I can use. But we will see, and I will take you guys along on the shoot. So let me create the setup. Hey guys, I am back. Yesterday I didn't have any time to finish this video, so we are finishing it today, I hope, I think. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna close the curtains, hope that gets it dark enough in here. Then I'm going to use this light here to illuminate the subject. I am going to take the photo on my phone, and I am going to use the table that's right there. Oh, that table. I'm gonna clean it out and then see how it goes. For this shot, I think it's important to have the light. You can probably just use the table light. I just have this and I'm very happy with it, so I will use it. Might even use it in this form. Yes, I will just get started. I will create a setup and I'll talk to you guys after the photo shoot. Welcome back. We did a shoot. We used the two different setups, as you might have seen in the b-roll. One was just the lamp or the light, and one was the light combined with the diffuser cap. So the results of the first setup were these photos. You see a very clear shadow of the camera, and you see some light, something in the background is lit as well. When you move on to the second camera or the second setup, you see nothing in the background, and you see a bit less harsh of a shadow of the camera. That is what the diffuser cap does. It diffuses the light, so it's more all-round. I like the photos from the second setup better. When we look at the original photo, we see that it does have some similarities, but it is also a very different photo. Even though the camera is exactly the same and lighting setup is mostly the same, I chose a red hue of the lighting because Sony has the red thingies, this red accents. Red is one of my favorite colors. It gave it a bit more personality together with the strap, which is brown, and the tabletop, which was brown. I want it to be a clean photo, but with some more personality, and I think that I did well. Although, to be fair, if I tried, I don't think I could have created such a clean photo as guys did. Yeah, all in all, this was a fun challenge. I really liked to play with the setup and the colors and trying to take the most out of my phone, because that was also quite a challenge. Thanks so much for watching, guys. If you like this video, please consider liking. Also, if you want to see more of my video, hit that subscribe button. And if you want to get notified when I post new videos, hit the bell button. And if you have a good name for this photo series, please let me know in the comments. I appreciate you guys a lot, and I'll see you in the next one.